Hello. In this video, we will discuss fueling energy needs during exercise and the factors influencing energy production. The picture you see on the screen represents energy metabolism. You should already be familiar with this from previous modules, but today we're going to discuss energy metabolism specifically during exercise. There's three key concepts to keep in mind, and the first is ATP. ATP is the high energy compound that the body uses for energy, so this is the end result of all energy metabolism pathways. The body must generate more ATP molecules to keep up with an increased demand, such as during exercise in a muscle cell. ATP, however, is only available for about 5 seconds of time. So there's different pathways that we can use to produce energy, and the first category of those pathways is anaerobic metabolism. Anaerobic means without oxygen. You can see in the picture over here, these are the systems that are taking place outside of the mitochondria. There's two pathways within anaerobic metabolism, and that's the ATP creatine phosphate system or glycolysis. Either way, you end up with a buildup of lactic acid because you don't have that oxygen available to continue and move pyruvate into acetyl-CoA in the mitochondria. When we do have oxygen available, we can have aerobic metabolism. This means with oxygen. So aerobic metabolism is typically limited by the amount of oxygen the respiratory system can deliver and consume, and that's represented by a person's VO2 max. This can be increased through respiratory fitness, but the important thing to keep in mind here is that aerobic is slower while anaerobic is quicker but limited. So let's flip over here and we'll look at these three systems and which one takes place during which type of exercise. So you can see on this chart here, these first two actually both represent anaerobic. And so we have the ATP creatine phosphate, which is without oxygen, and then this anaerobic in yellow, which is equal to what we call glycolysis. And then our blue line represents aerobic metabolism. So in the chart, we'll talk about each. For anaerobic, we'll start with the ATP creatine phosphate, and our fuel source is either going to be that readily available ATP within the first 5 seconds, or we're going to have ADP plus the creatine phosphate. So the phosphate will bind and turn that into ATP with one step. In glycolysis, we're having carbohydrates, which we're breaking down into glucose. And that's going to be the same in aerobic when we use carbohydrates. We're going to break that down into glucose. Or we can use fats, turn them into fatty acids, which will go directly to acetyl-CoA. The duration we're talking about here, you can see in this chart, where the ATP creatine phosphate is going to only be about 1 to 10 seconds. For glycolysis, then we're looking at about 10 to 200 seconds. And then if we're switching over to aerobic metabolism and still using carbohydrate, we're talking about 5 minutes plus. So your body has about 2,500 calories stored. And once we use that up, if we're consuming carbohydrates, then we can keep using it. But otherwise, we're going to have to switch over to fats, which we can use for hours. However, the intensity we can maintain. We can do high intensity using the ATP creatine phosphate system, and then it's going to be lower as we go across this chart. So activities you might think about for ATP creatine phosphate would be something like weightlifting or a 100-yard dash. For glycolysis, we might be looking at an 800-meter dash. And then if we're using the aerobic system and relying on carbohydrates, you might think about a 5K race, so it's high intensity but lasting longer, whereas fats might be a day-long hike or something at lower intensity that's lasting for a longer period of time. One more way to think about this, in the aerobic system specifically, for fats and carbohydrates is that it's a balancing act. So we have our carbohydrates on one side, our fats on the other, and it's going to be a balancing act between intensity and duration. So as the intensity goes up, the duration is going to have to go down because we can't maintain that, and we're going to be relying on carbohydrates, but we're going to run out, so we're going to have to lower our intensity, and then we can switch over to using fats. All right, that's all I have for you today.